Hi friends, welcome to my channel. I am super excited for this video because I am going to share you 10 amazing tips to become a full-time artist. Also, I am answering few of your questions related to this. I did not study art or drawing in my academics, but I am a full-time artist now. I studied M.Pharmacy. I have worked in medical field more than 8 years, but now I have turned into full-time artist very recently. It's about 2 months ago. So here I wanted to share those 10 amazing tips what I have followed to become a full-time artist. Watch the complete video to get most amazing tips, and also I'll answer few of your questions at the end. Here the tip 1. If you are passionate about doing something and you want to turn it as a profession, then you need to have a separate social media profiles for your art, drawing, whatever it is. And you need to be consistently posting them in your social media. In the beginning, I had personal Instagram, which I have turned into arts account. At that time, I had nearly 100 followers in my profile. From there, I have started posting my art, and I have deleted all my personal photos, and I kept only my drawings in there. And also, I have created separate page in my Facebook for my drawings alone. That is how I have started 2.5 years ago. Tip 2. This is not a magic. You are not going to become a full-time artist in 1 or 2 months. That might happen to someone, but it is not practical for everybody. Don't be over-expecting in the initial days. This is the phase where you will be working on your regular job, and also you will be doing your hobby as a part-time. And also it is a learning period for you. You will be getting to know many things in this period. Don't quit very soon before you get the results, because it takes time. You must have that patience or consistency to achieve something in your life. Here comes third tip. As I told you, this is a learning period. It is not only that you have to improve in your hobby or artwork. You also have to learn many things about the social media, because I hear there is nobody to promote your work in magazines or the famous newspapers or something like that. So you have to work for yourself. You have to build the social media networks. So we need to be learning about the social medias, which are present, they are relevant in the generation, and where you can get the most of the traffic. You need to know how to use the social media and how to present your artwork over there, and how often you have to post and how often you have to make reels or something like that if you are using Instagram. So you have to learn so many things, and now there is lot of information available in the internet, so you can learn on your own. You don't have to do any social media courses here. If you can afford, you can do that, but otherwise also there are many options for you to learn. My fourth tip is, do not try to be on every other social media which is available now, because there are plenty of social medias available now. So you can use Pinterest, you can use Instagram, you can use YouTube videos, and you can use Twitter and TikTok. There are many things. But if you try to be active on all the social media platforms, what happens? After some days, you feel like there is lot of burden on you, and you cannot concentrate on all of this at a time. So you might quit after few days. So to avoid this, what you can do? Initially, you develop any two social medias. Once you are comfortable in using those two social medias, when you learn really good about those things, then you can switch it to some other along with those two social media networks what you have. Like that, you can slowly increase your social media presence. When I started, I just started with the Facebook page and Instagram. Now I am including YouTube into it. I am seeing really good results when I started doing YouTube, because YouTube also gets SEO related traffic. So it is really useful if you can include YouTube in your social media platform. And also it is evergreen content. And even after 5 or 6 years, if someone are looking for particular topic what you are doing, then they can find your profile. So that is the benefit of using YouTube. So I am really looking forward to explore more on the YouTube now. And the fifth tip here, if you are creating portrait drawings, cartoons, paintings, whatever it can be, you need to develop your own style. Do not copy others. When you are starting out, you don't know anything. That time you might copy from your senior artist. But eventually, you have to develop your own style. For this, what you have to do, you just don't follow any one artist. You learn from many different artists, and you pick up good things from everywhere and start developing your own style. Why am I telling this? Because if there is already a famous artist doing particular type of work and he is very famous, why would people come to you? Because he is a original, so people tend to go to that artist only. If some people approaches you also, they will expect you to do in very less price when compared to that famous artist. That is why you don't copy any famous artist. Learn from many and develop your own style. And this is very important tip what I am going to tell you now. The sixth tip is have a particular niche to your content. That means you follow any one particular art forms when you are beginning. For example, if you are doing pencil drawings, you do only pencil drawings. If you are doing charcoal drawings, you do only charcoal drawings. If you are into watercolor, you do only watercolors. You might tell there are many artists who are doing multiple things. That might work after some years. Once you already get famous, that might work. But when you want to attract similar kind of audience in your profile, then you have to be doing only one style so that people can relate with you, and who are interested in that particular style, they will follow you. So initially you just start with any one art form. Once you gain the momentum, then you can experiment on different mediums. Another pro tip here. The seventh one, you have to help people in your community. That means if you are good at doing something and people are liking your work, what happens? There will be many people who wants to take tips from you. They want to learn from you. So when people are following you, they expect to get some value from you. So you just start sharing tips in your profile, not just the artworks. You also share some tips so that who wants to learn those and they can connect with you, and they will be your core audience. Here I am going to give you very important tip. Eighth tip is time management. You need to know how to manage your time because you are working on multiple things here. You are also working in your regular job and also trying to build your hobby. Okay, so this takes lot of efforts and lot of time. So you need to be managing your time really well. I am focusing on it. You need to be managing your time really well. For this, what you have to do? You have to stop spending time on unnecessary things. You just go through your daily routine and you analyze how your time is distributed. You are already doing a full-time job. That might include some traveling time also. So 10 hours will go there, and you might spend some 8 hours for sleeping. That means 18 hours are going there. And you have to prepare your food or whatever. You have to get ready for that, maybe some 2 to 3 hours. So rest 2 or 3 hours are left, right? So in that, you might be spending that time in entertainment or something like that. So there you have to work on, and you have to cut off unnecessary things like watching TV or simply scrolling on the social media profiles, or simply spending on the window shopping and spending time on Amazon watching clothes or something but you never buy. Those things you need to cut off. So when I was working in my full-time job, what I used to do, like once after I come back from my work, I used to quickly prepare dinner and I have dinner. After dinner, I'll start drawing. At least for 2 to 2.5 hours, I'll draw. After that, I go to sleep. So this is how I manage from 2.5 years. So every day, 10 p.m. to 12 p.m., I used to draw. Also, I used to draw on weekends. So if you want to manage all these things, there is an important tip which you have to follow. So ninth tip is manage your energy levels throughout the day. So if you want to manage your energy levels throughout the day, then you have to be healthy, right? You need to be energetic all the time. So you need to be healthy. For that, you need to have good food. Mainly the food which is rich of vegetables and fruits, that will maintain your high energy levels throughout the day. So this has worked for me. I hope this will work for you also if you follow it. And the another important thing is, you need to do some exercise, meditation, yoga, something to improve your focus and also mental stability, also physical stamina. So if you follow all these, you will have the energy levels high and you don't fall sick in between, so that you don't need so much rest time. So you can utilize your time more efficiently in this way. Another important thing here, that is the 10th tip. So you have to manage your money so well, because in the beginning, you may not have any art supplies to start. These art supplies are not really so cheap as outside people think. only artists know that how expensive these art supplies are, right? So in the beginning, you really don't have any income from your art. So in this time, you just have to manage from the earnings of your regular job. So for that, you already have so many commitments from your salary. Now, how do you manage to buy art supplies? For that, what you have to do? You have to cut off unnecessary expenses. You may think that I am not spending any unnecessary money, but you just go through like on what all you are spending. You might be spending on clothes and whatever. I am not saying those are unnecessary things, but if you compare what is important, spending money on clothes every week or every month, is that important? Or spending money for your art supplies, which is very important for you, and also it can turn into your profession someday. So which is important for you? You just think and spend accordingly. Save some money, stop spending on unnecessary things, and buy your art supplies. I gave all of my 10 pro tips in this video. Now let me answer your valuable questions. I have received many questions from you in my Instagram. So I am going to answer all the relevant questions here. You may get your turn too. So watch the video completely. If you are already not following my Instagram, then please check the link in the description box. I have added the link. You can directly communicate with me through my stories or chat box in the Instagram. Let's see what is the first question here. Someone is asking me, when did you know that this is what you wanted to do or loved? This is really a good question. Actually, I knew that I love drawing from the childhood, but I really didn't think that I can take it as a profession in that time. Because if you go back to 20 years now, that time we did not have any social media or something like that. So I really didn't know that we can make income out of drawing. Because of my studies and job, I have left drawing in between. So just before 3 years, I just started drawing again. This time I was more focused and more passionate about drawing. I don't know why. And I just learned so many things. Like I just improved my skills a lot. So that time I came to know, maybe it happened 2.5 years ago. So this is what I love doing for my whole life. So I just started focusing more and more on it. Someone is asking me which course you did. So as I told you before, I did not do any drawing related courses. When I just restarted drawing again three years ago, I just registered for one course in Udemy, that is realistic drawing course. I really didn't know what exactly the title was, but I could not continue the course. I just left it after one or two lessons. But I continued learning by watching YouTube drawing tutorials and also some blog pages. I just researched a lot about realistic drawing. That is what interested me so much in that particular time. So someone is asking how to sell my artworks and also how to get commissioned artworks constantly. How to sell my artworks? This I don't know probably because I have not sold any of my artworks, but I do lot of commissioned works. From past 2.5 years, I think I did more than 35 commissioned works, and maximum I did all the commissioned works in this year only. How did I get the regular commissioned works? That is the question, right? Okay, so my tip is that you have to do your work consistently, and also you have to make sure that your work reaches to many people. So that you have to learn the platforms. You know how to use the platform efficiently, then you can reach more people. Someone is asking, what if we don't get succeeded as full-time artist and what are the other options for us? If you didn't get succeeded as full-time artist, then maybe you have to go to what you were doing before. But why this question comes? You need to be like committed for what you are doing, right? So you just don't quit your regular job until you get some amount of success here, okay? You focus on marketing your artworks everywhere. So you need to be appearing in the Google search and you need to be appearing in Instagram, like, so whatever the platforms are available currently, so you need to focus on them. And also you need to improve your art skills. So so that people like your artwork and also it is reaching to right audience, then you may not have this question of being not succeeded. And also you need to focus on multiple income streams if you want to become a full-time artist. You cannot expect to become a full-time artist only on doing commissions. You need to have other income streams as well. So because you already have some type of skill, you can start teaching them. So you may get some money from that also. So that is what I am doing. I get more income from teaching rather than doing commissions. Also, I am focusing on improving my passive income through YouTube videos or making some recorded course sessions. So don't only depend on the commission works. You just increase your income streams. You have to diversify your income streams, but if you want to sustain in this field. Someone is asking how to deal with back pain issue. Okay, I did not get this issue many times because I take many breaks in between. I get up half an hour or 1 hour once in between when I am drawing and I walk around, then I come back. So I did not get this issue. Maybe this will work for you also. You just get up in between, walk around and then come back and continue your work. And also, see if the table and your chair is comfortable or not. Because even I was using a normal plastic chair for these many days. So, newly I got this chair. This is very comfortable. But before I was using normal plastic chair. So, that height was not comfortable for me. Even I used to get back pain if I sit on the plastic chair. So to increase the height, what I used to do, I used to spread my bed sheet and the chair and I used to keep pillow behind so that will support my back so that I will not get any discomfort or back pain. So like that, you have to find out what is causing you back pain and try to get solutions for that. So someone is asking, being a full-time artist, is there any available satisfying income? This is an interesting question. Yeah, as I told you before, initially you may not get any satisfying income. I used to get some 3,000 to 4,000 per month initially when I started. Now that is not the case because I can create more artwork in a month and also I am getting more commission works now and also I teach. Yeah, I am getting quite satisfactory income. So like this, you need to diversify your income streams. So there are many options to diversify your income streams. If you don't know what are the income streams as an artist, please check this video I have added in the card. That will help you. Okay, someone is asking, when to turn to a full-time artist? Based on the number of commissioned works or how? Yeah, this is really interesting question. You just notice in your career, if you have already captured that momentum in your social media, that you are increasing your followers and you are increasing your commissioned works, and if there is an opportunity for you to diversify your income streams, might be through teaching, conducting workshops or something like that, or also YouTube videos. So my suggestion is, don't depend only on the commissioned work. So that is not in your hands, right? So you need to diversify your income streams before you turn into a full-time artist. When you have to take this decision is, you must be earning at least 50% income from your side hustle as compared to your regular job. So that is the time you can make this decision, according to me. Okay, someone is asking, how often do you get commissions? I get commissions like maybe 4 to 5 in a month. I get many requests for the commission drawings, but I accept only 4 or 5 commission works because doing commission works is really so much time taking. So I don't take more than that. Okay, the most interesting question here. What is your future plans and your ambitions? Me, my future plans are to be very successful in this field and I must be an example that some other artists get inspired by seeing me, that okay, even we can earn or we can choose this field as a career. So I want to make people feel in that way. That is my ambition. And my goals are, I am planning to prepare few courses, like few portrait drawing courses, and I want to launch them in Udemy or like any other platform, Skillshare or somewhere like that. So those are the goals right now. And also I want to get my YouTube channel monetized, and also I want my YouTube channel to reach many people so that people who were like me, they wanted to learn but they did not have that economical support, so they want to learn it freely. So for them, my YouTube channel need to be very helpful. So these are the ambitions or goals right now. Thank you for asking these questions. I really enjoyed making this video. I hope you like this. And if you have not yet subscribed, please subscribe. I'll be making weekly art tutorials and these kind of videos in this channel. So if you want to know more about earning as an artist, then check the videos I have added in the end screen. Thank you. Bye bye. Take care.